My name is Dr. Beintaris. I'm one of the consultant gastroenterologists in Ortiz. Today, I'm going to walk you through your upcoming polypectomy procedure. So what happens before your procedure? One of our pre-assessment nurses will contact you to discuss the procedure with you, and you will also be receiving your appointment in writing with details on the date and time. We will also be posting you the relevant procedure information leaflet together with a consent form for your reference and perusal before you attend on the actual day of the procedure. Sometimes we may need to ask you or organize for you to attend the hospital or your surgery to submit some blood samples as part of preparations for your procedure. Rarely, we may also deem that a scan is appropriate for you to help us assess your pathology before actually removing it. We will be sending you laxatives for you to drink the day before your procedure. In rare cases where patients have a constipation history, this laxative regimen may be extended to a few more days. So what does EMR technique stand for? EMR stands for endoscopic mucosal resection. This technique essentially involves injection of specialized fluid underneath the polyp with the use of a particular very thin needle. This allows the polyp to be detached from the bowel wall, subsequently allowing us to slowly resect the polyp or remove it with the help of a metallic snare. So what is a polyp? A polyp is an abnormal growth that may develop inside your bowel, usually what we call the large bowel or colon. So why do we need to remove polyps from your bowel? Polyps are abnormal growths that may have the potential to become cancers if left behind in the future. They also have the potential to cause symptoms that may cause you trouble, such as diarrhea, constipation, or even bleeding and anemia. Therefore, if you have been deemed appropriate to have your polyp removed, you should strongly consider it to mitigate those risks. So what will happen on the day of the procedure? Once you have arrived, you will inform our reception that you are at the endoscopy unit, and you will be greeted by one of our endoscopy nurses who will lead you into what we call an admission room. This is where we will take some time to go through your comorbidities, medical issues, and medications before proceeding to the consenting process. During the consenting process, either your doctor or one of the qualified nurses will walk you through details about the procedure, including risks, and if you're happy to proceed, you will be asked to countersign the form. Once this process is over, you will be asked to wait in one of our waiting rooms until your endoscopy room is ready for the procedure to start. So what are the risks involved in a polypectomy procedure? As with any procedure, especially an interventional one, there are always some risks which you need to be aware of. It is worthwhile noting that these risks are not common, but they do occur. Risks that we may encounter during a polypectomy procedure might involve pain during the procedure, bleeding, a tear in the bowel, or in medical terms, a perforation, and some sedation risks in case you opt to have sedation for the procedure. It is important to know that these complications are not common, but if they occur, they may potentially have serious implications, in which case we may opt to keep you in the hospital overnight for monitoring and further management. You will be having the chance to go through more details on these complications in the patient information leaflet that will be posted to you when your procedure is booked. Are there any alternatives to your polypectomy procedure? One option is not to remove the polyp by accepting the risks that this polyp entails. As mentioned earlier, polyps do have the potential to grow in size and also give rise to cancers. Therefore, if you opt to have your polyp not removed but left in your bowel, this is a risk you may need to accept. Another alternative, if the polyp is eventually deemed appropriate for resection, is a surgical operation that can be done either with open surgery or a keyhole surgery. Obviously, surgery is a more invasive technique, and if you eventually contemplate this option, there will be a different assessment pathway for you before the procedure is undertaken. So what happens during and after your procedure? Before the procedure is started, we often administer what we call conscious sedation. This is usually a combination of a mild sedative together with a painkiller to prevent you from having significant discomfort during your procedure. The EMR polypectomy technique may take anywhere from half an hour to a full hour, depending on the complexity of your polyp. After the procedure is completed, you will be transferred to our recovery unit, where your observations will be taken. We will ensure you're feeling okay to have a snack and a drink before we start your discharge process. Just to assure you that before you're discharged from the hospital, you will receive a lot of information about what happened in your procedure, including details of who and when to contact if you experience any problems or side effects as a result of your procedure.